What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Let's Talk Nerd, and welcome to Season 5 of Halo the Master Chief Collection. So, as you may have seen in updates, there's a lot of new cosmetics for Halo 3 and Halo Reach, but there is a new seasonal challenge. It is called Release the Geese, and there's the one and only skin for the Mongoose. It's a Hazard Pay Mongoose skin, a little yellow and black, but ultimately you need to beat the final mission of Halo 3, Halo, on Legendary difficulty, with all players in Mongooses to earn the Hazard Pay Mongoose skin. So that wording, saying all players, does not mean that you have to do this with co-op players. Like, you don't have to have four players, like annual, Vidmaster annual, with all the ghosts or anything. You can do the solo, which is what I'm going to show you today. So to start things off, you're going to make sure you go to Halo 3. You're going to choose Halo as your mission. Doesn't matter on competitive score or competitive time, anything like that. You're going to want to make sure you're on Legendary difficulty. And for lulz, we'll turn on I Would Have Been Your Daddy. And Cowbell. No, we won't do Cowbell. But you don't need any skulls or anything like that. And then you're just going to start things up. All right, starting off here, I'm just going to try to show you guys the fastest way to complete this mission as possible. Mine aren't going to be a super speed run, but we're just going to do this. So as you see here, the Down Pelican has a variety of weapons you're going to choose. You're going to want to make sure you pick up a BR. That's going to be the main weapon you're going to want to use on this. The rocket launcher, we're going to use it maybe two times, and then we're going to drop it. And then you're going to want to make your way to the main area. Alright, once you get to the main area, there's going to be a bunch of flood dropping and spawning here. There's always going to be one flood that spawns with the hammer right there. You're going to kill it and take the hammer. Kill as many floods as you can. Since you're on Legendary, you're going to get hit a little bit harder. And you're going to make your way up to this peninsula up here. Now, this is a little bit of a trick jump. It's not super difficult to, but, you know, it's going to take a little bit of precision. So you might get start getting hammered in the back by these guys. You're going to want to make sure you're full shields before you try this jump. So I'm going to knock a couple of these guys out. They're just going to keep shooting me. All right. Normally you can get away with it and not get hit before you do this, but we're just having some bad RNG here. So what you're going to want to do, you want to make sure you're not using your frag grenades, and you're going to want to throw one on the ground here, and then you're going to grenade jump up here into the siding. You're not going to slide off or anything like that. Once you hit that siding, it should give you some foothold. And you're just going to want to make your way up to the top of the tower as usual. Now, while you're doing this, all the flood are going to try to get up here to the top because they all spawn on the bottom. But you just want to run past them as much as you can. Most of them will probably ignore you because the Sentinels and the Arbiter will take hold. But you have the hammer here, and that is going to allow you to knock these guys out super quick. Again, you're on Legendary, so just a few hits will knock you out, but as you can see, we made it up here pretty easily. There's going to be two auto turrets up here on the platform. Just go ahead and throw those. They're going to be cannon fodder for us. If you want to be super safe, you can come up here and do this jump. Go up here. And then walk up this ramp, and you can go hang out with Johnson while he shoots the laser. And since you have a BR, you have a good vantage point to take out the lesser form flubs. Floods, well, not flubs. Finally doing what he wanted. Now, Johnson and the Arbiter can take out most of these floods on their own. If you ran out of ammo up here and you don't want to risk dying, you can ultimately just sit here as long as you want, and they'll eventually kill all of them. The Arbiter can't die, and Johnson can't die just yet. But we're going to help him out, use as much BR as we can, and knock these guys out as quickly as possible. Now, as you can see here, there are a lot of range form floods that will try to knock you out. So if you're gonna hold up here and wait for the AI to kill everything for you, you're gonna want to stay back here. You can ultimately walk to that doorway that you'll go into later in the level. There's no kill box here or anything like that, so you should be good. We got a few checkpoints here, so you can mess up if you need to. We're gonna go out down here and take this hammer and try to knock these guys out. Once you have all the flood cleared out, Johnson will come down, and you'll proceed on to your fight with 343 Guilty Spark. Now, 343 Guilty Spark battle is no different than any other difficulty. He will knock you out a little bit quicker if you stand there and let the beam hit you, but he ultimately just fires it randomly. Johnson accidentally shoots me with the shotgun and kills me. That would have been awesome. So they just take out 343 as usual. Three hits will do it. One of the easiest boss battles of like any game. Johnson dies, of course, and then we will proceed on to the Warthog run, but in this challenge case, we are going to be doing the Mongoose.
I am sorry, Spark. Come.
So if you followed pretty much what I've done to a T so far, you're looking at about 8 minutes to get to this point. Maybe a little bit quicker if you go and kill the flood a little bit quicker. Now at this point, the flood and sentinels are going to be attacking you, so having dual plasma rifles is kind of the best option right now. At least until you get to the vehicles. When you get out of here, there's going to be two sentinels that come by. Just go ahead and take those out. Now, Vivmaster Annual, you would take a left and go down here under the stairs, and there'd be four ghosts. But we're not going to do that. There's no challenge for that right now. So you're just going to proceed on as usual. Kill all the floods, just be careful. Now, when you go into this tunnel, there's going to be flood and sentinels fighting. So don't just rush in, try to peek through the door and take out as many as you can first. I would focus on the sentinels since they're more ranged. Most of these floods just have plasma rifles. Again, Arbiter will take care of most of these guys if you just let them. Just let them help you out. Carrier forms are pretty easy, you just blow them up and then kind of jump around. Make sure the flood forms don't actually get you. And when you walk up this ramp, there's going to be a crap ton of small flood forms. You can usually shoot and pop them all at once. Just like that.
There, Johnson's Warthog.
So, normally, you have this Warthog, right? But there's some mongooses. Somewhere around here. Right?
Come on, Spartan. Go, go, go!
So you're gonna take the Warthog down this slope. Now, generally, you can get a chopper here on the left side. But we're not gonna show you that. We're gonna go down here. A little bit out of the way, you don't have to worry about everything blowing up. So the mongoose is going to be located right here, and then you're just going to proceed through the level as you normally would, but you're going to be on the mongoose. Keep in mind that the mongoose is a lot slower, so some of these jumps are going to be a little difficult, so don't get too frustrated if you wind up missing some of the jumps because you're going too slow. You're going to flip a lot more easier. And yeah, it's not the most easiest thing to do, but it's definitely doable. The big thing here is that the Arbiter is not going to be on your back, killing any of the Flood. If you run over any of these Flood forms, you're going to wind up flipping just like that. I got turned around real easy. So it can definitely be super annoying. Just make sure you go off ramps straight. You're not going off curved, otherwise you'll wind up flipping. And don't be surprised if you get killed by the Sentinels. Oh, this is rough. This is so rough.
10%. Firing sequence initiated.
And that's all there is to it, guys. So it is a little difficult. I died quite a few times. I don't know how many times. I don't think it says here. But the things you got to remember is to always go off any ramps or try to avoid any ramps as much as you can. Just try to follow the path that I took. Because like if you go off like a big ramp, you're more than likely going to flip. The mongoose is super, super sketchy when you're going over ramps and things like that. Try to go over the ramps that are more level and not the ones that just go straight up and then there's like an actual jump. Go for the ones like on the left. They're usually towards the left side, not down the middle and things like that. And then you should be fine. This is going to be a lot easier, I think, if you have a co-op partner. But it's definitely doable solo, as I just showed. If you just have a co-op partner, the person on the back can easily take the sentinel shots while you're driving the mongoose, and then I think they can ultimately respawn as you get to like each tower that falls and things like that. So that's it. Hope that was helpful, guys. If it was, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more of my Halo content, and I have some other content as well on YouTube, but I'd love to have you on board. Be looking for more guides on Master Chief Collection Season 5. See you next time, guys.